This is Kelly Hill, technology reporter for RCR Wireless News. I'm here today with Derek Edwards, who is CEO of Globus. Derek, welcome.
Thank you.
And I'm wondering if you can start us off by giving us a snapshot of Globus, and we're going to be talking about big data telecom analytics today, so hopefully you can give us a sense of how you guys fit into the ecosystem.
Absolutely. So at Globus, we're a big data analytics company, and we specialize in combining advanced scientific methods, big data, and marketing to deliver contextual marketing solutions to service providers that allows one-to-one, true one-to-one communications with their customers.
Okay. Great. Well, let's talk about some of the timing and the trends that are going on in the market right now. And maybe you can start us off by talking about, you know, what is going on now and why is now an important time for companies to be thinking about telecom analytics, how they're going to use it, and where they're going to put their money.
Yeah. So with the carriers, there's the market dynamics, is tough for them. So as their voice revenues and other text revenues fall, the data is not quite growing as fast as they would hope. The over-the-top players are looking to attack them anywhere they possibly can. And there's this shift for the carriers from acquisition of customers to actually monetization of their base. So really looking at more of a customer-centric approach requires greater sophistication for what they're doing. Instead of in the past where maybe they would look at normal telecom analytics that people understand are maybe like BI tools and dashboards and things, it really requires greater real-time decisions and actions. You combine that with companies like ours that have been investing tens of millions of dollars into developing big data solutions that can be truly transformational for these carriers. Here we can handle large, massive amounts of data that even 2 years ago we weren't able to do in a real-time versus batch direction, which really allows the machine learning to maximize the performance for the carrier's campaign. I'm going to say one more point that, you know, at that point the carriers are able to make more intelligent decisions in what they're doing, and kind of the key areas that they're trying to drive are increased revenue, some operational efficiencies and such. And so it's a key time for the carriers, and the analytics are things that we can really make some impact.
Okay. You mentioned the potential for some fairly transformative things here when it comes to implementing these things. So where do operators see the biggest opportunities?
Yeah, analytics itself isn't really new, but the big data analytics is. So the capability to analyze huge data sets at a reasonable cost is new. And so this allows the opportunity for the carriers to look at more specific solutions and down to a one-to-one level of customers, even if they have tens of millions of customers. So the carriers that we've been working with are very focused on finding areas where they can find measurable impact and be able to easily show that for a business case. Now, luckily with big data analytics, you're able to easily show the impact exactly what you're doing. So that makes it very useful internally for the carriers to push these solutions through. But the areas that we've seen carriers focusing on, so operational efficiency, churn reduction, and driving more revenue, and specifically within there on the operational efficiency side, we're seeing carriers using big data to understand their network utilization performance, to actually find the exact specific spots where they're having failures within their network. On the churn side, they're preventing multi-SIM purchases where customers are buying multiple SIMs, swapping those out. They're spending a lot of time migrating customers from prepay to postpay, as well as identifying customers from a social influencer perspective, and then being able to nurture those customers. And then on the revenue generation side, the more interesting areas that we're seeing are where they're stimulating data usage, driving more value there, as well as some carriers are utilizing the big data. They're selling their solutions selling their data, their customer data, to third-party advertisers. And they're using the big data to then be able to show how there's more value there as they're driving. And that's a relatively new area, though.
Okay. So it sounds like there's both sort of internal benefit to be had as well as new revenue streams there potentially.
Absolutely.
Okay, good, good. So let's talk about companies that are, you know, things that you see leading the market. How would you characterize the ones leading the pack in terms of advancing the application of these analytics? You know, where are they really applying? You mentioned some examples of how these can be applied, but I'm just wondering if you can give us some more perspective in that area.
Yeah, from the carriers that we work with, you can really look at them as three different areas of where they're driving, leading the pack. So from a competitive standpoint, if they're in a competitive market, they need to do something. What's interesting is in the past we used to see that it was the new vendor in the competitive market that would come in with something new and advanced. What we're actually finding now in some of our markets are it's actually the market incumbent that had been sitting back comfortable for many years now realizing that they can't compete with the new competitor without some new tools. And so they're actually leapfrogging the competition. And for them, they actually maybe didn't even invest as heavily in some of the older tools that are out there. So it's truly they're skipping a generation of telecom analytics. We're also finding prepaid carriers that have large prepaid bases. What's interesting about the prepaid market is customers make a lot of decisions every single day related to their services. We actually have a customer that, when you look at the size of big data here, that customer has more data than all of Facebook combined when you look at it from a customer purchase or customer interaction. And what we see is that customer does each individual user on the prepaid platform is doing at least 29 purchase decisions a day, whether that's to top up or whether you use services or whatnot. On Facebook, it's 3. So this customer that has 100 million customers has way more data. And we're able to leverage that data and then be able to get very specific for that customer. The last area that where the telecoms that are really driving it is if you have a senior leader within the carrier, typically the CMO, that is really open to doing something transformational, then they're able to drive that through the organization.
Okay. So leadership is definitely important then.
Absolutely.
Okay. Great. So with data as this foundation, what kind of new generation strategies and techniques are we talking about here? You've mentioned that you know you can that there's a lot of potential here. So how do you transform that into real world intelligence?
Yeah. So what we do is we take big data, we combine it with the marketing and science, and essentially we're able to track everything that a customer does over their entire life cycle with the carrier. Then we can apply dynamic behavior modeling that we update real time to then generate these contextual offers to the customer or information pieces. So instead of, in some markets we work with, they typically would just spam all their customers. with campaigns. We get very specific. We actually use less messages than normal, but the take rate of our messages is substantial. At one customer we were working with, they had never seen above 2% take rate on any of their below-the-line marketing campaigns. Right out of the gate, we were driving 10x that volume, that we were in the 20-plus percent take rates. And then we see long-term effects from a KPI perspective, that churn reduction at that given customer, we were able to decrease it 10%. And if you think about this from a customer perspective, they feel like the carrier actually knows them. We're able to leverage the information. We know what they're going to do and when, and we can anticipate that and be able to offer them the right offer. And we do that through some advanced science. So we use dynamic state space modeling, it's called, and it goes beyond predictive modeling. And what we are able to do with this is we're able to analyze the whole customer's life cycle. And it's not only that we know with a high probability of what they're going to do next, but we know what they're going to do 4 or 5 or 6 steps down the line. So it's kind of like being an expert chess player, that you can anticipate the other customer's move, and not just their next move, but their next 5 or 6 moves, and you can know where you want to go and how you could nudge or influence that customer to get them to go in the direction that's optimal for you and optimal for them.
Well, speaking of kind of looking into the future and that, you know, next step after the next step after the next step, are operators leveraging the existing data and analytics assets that they have to help offset future investments? Are, you know, can you give us an idea of the alignment there and where the bigger gap, where the gaps are and how they're filling them?
You know, they definitely are leveraging some of their investments that they've made. So they've invested in data warehouses and BI tools and campaign management platforms. And all of those can be used in general with what we're doing. Some of those systems do have limitations in that the systems are maybe very manual or batch process in the way that they do things. And to do this effectively, we really need to move to where data flows much more regularly into a real-time or even near real-time approach. Some of the other legacy systems also have some scale issues related to number of campaigns. We have ways that we've been able to work around this, but you know, I was with one carrier recently, and we were talking to them and what they wanted to accomplish, and they had just finished implementing a new campaign management implementation. I'm sure they spent millions of dollars on it, and it was from, you know, one of the top software companies in the world. And we were talking about the different campaigns they wanted to try, and they had we estimated it was about 10,000 different combinations of offer, you know, message, tone, you know, variety of different things that we wanted to test the effectiveness of. And their current campaign management could handle between 15 and 20. So that adds some complexity that you have to work around that. But ultimately with them, we were able to go through, we tested those. We ended up testing about 5,000 was the final combination. And we were able to come back and tell them which 2% drove significant lift. Now, when you think about that, in the old world, you would never try that many to start with. But even if you did, you wouldn't necessarily understand which ones worked until long after the fact. But even more importantly, the carriers don't understand which ones don't work. And that's something that with our system, we're just as focused on what things work as we are as what things don't work. And we figure out what doesn't work quickly and turn it off. And if you turn off the things that aren't working and you scale the things that are, you can drive some significant results.
Okay, so let's talk a little bit more about that. It sounds like we're really, what we're really getting at is kind of is optimizing the how you're using the information that you get. So how far along are operators in kind of making that transformation from, you know, yes, we have a lot of information and we have some legacy systems that allow us to do some things, to kind of optimizing, yes, we have the right information and we can get it to we can get things to people at the right time, we can do it efficiently, you know, and when we can really see that this is working for us, and if it's not working, then we adjust. You know, so how far along are we in kind of getting to that optimizing stage?
There's still a little ways to go. Now, the things that we ask for from a carrier, we're asking for individual usage records, all things that they have somewhere in their systems and processes. So getting that information and kind of to that level of granularity is key. And it's something they have. It just takes a little bit of time to find the right feeds and to be able to get that to come across. Some of their internal processes, though, where you want to be more automated, typically we find that they're a little bit more batch. So we need to work with them to figure out, okay, how we can automate some of these things. And essentially what we want to do there is we want to speed up for the operator and for the marketer the time it takes from conceptualizing what they want to do to understanding if it's going to work. Today, that end-to-end cycle takes months. You know, some they come up with an idea, they go talk to their BI team, they then roll that idea out, run it for a few months, and then go back to the BI team and say, please let me know how we did. With our process, we kind of turn that on its head, and we start out and we use the machine learning, and the machine actually goes out and tests all of these things and then is able to come back very quickly in some instances, like with prepay where they're making decisions every day. Within days, we could know what's working, what's not working for each individual customer. So you can look within the carriers. Again, if you have the CMO and the marketers that really want to do something different that drives real results, they can push it through. There's nothing here that we're doing that's impossible for the carrier. Some of it is just difficult with some of the processes or technologies that they have in place currently.
Okay. So, Derek, I'm going to ask you to for one final question to take out your crystal ball and give us some idea of where you think operators will be in terms of big data-driven telecom analytics, say, by 2019.
So 5 years out, you know, they need to be there. This is a transformation in the way that they approach interacting with their customers. And we're confident that the carriers that are going to be surviving at that time are going to be thriving because they're interacting with their customers in a much better way. To do that, you need to be one-to-one. To be one-to-one, you need to have the granularity and be able to utilize the big data. So for the carriers that are going to be successful at that time, this is going to be something that they're going to be using, not just for individual marketing campaigns, but they're going to need to use it widespread within their organization. And, you know, it's going to be a core competency for the carriers. You know, the way that the carriers are going to get there, they either need to do what we've done, which is, you know, investing tens of millions of dollars, hiring a lot of PhD scientists to be able to get there, or they're going to come find third-party companies like ourselves or others that can help get them there today instead of, you know, taking the time that they would normally take to build things.
It sounds like the investments that they're making today are probably going to be shaping where they're at in 5 years as well.
Absolutely. So, you know, this isn't going to turn around tomorrow for them. They've made very significant investments in data warehouses, campaign management systems, all of those things, kind of the legacy telecom analytics. This is a new way of thinking. a new way of approaching. There's pieces of those investments they can leverage, but they need to be able to be willing to try something new and not be locked in to their previous investment.
Okay. All right. Well, I've been talking with Derek Edwards, CEO of Globus. Derek, thanks so much for your time today.
Great. Thanks for having me.